Hello. Or should I say, howdy. I'm Lorne Greene, and welcome to Alberta. We're about 50 miles west of Calgary in the foothills of the magnificent Rocky Mountains. Folks around here call it God's country. And why not? Look around. The majestic Rockies, acre upon acre of beautiful green pastures for the finest beef cattle and the sleekest and sturdiest horses in the country. Makes a man feel good just being here. Now, back 60 years ago, one man had a dream for this part of the country. Considering the abundance of good horses and this incredible backdrop, why, people would come from miles around for the biggest and best frontier rodeo show in the world. Well, on September 2nd, 1912, Guy Wiedek's dream came true. And now we're celebrating the 60th year of the greatest outdoor show on earth. So welcome to the Calgary Stampede Diamond Jubilee.
Calgary Stampede Diamond Jubilee is brought to you by the First Canadian Bank, Bank of Montreal.
Right now, I'd like you to join me and all my friends and travel with us. Sure like to have you along.
We're headed for the roundup, going to the big stampede, and old Dick Cosgrove riding in the lead. The old Chuckwagon rattling, a snorting bucking Broncs. We're headed for the Calgary Stampede.
We're a jolly bunch of cowboys, we hope you are the same. We have no cares, the laws we never heed. Gather in a circle and sing a roundup song. We're headed for the Calgary Stampede.
Pick yourself a sweetheart and join the cowboy ball. Hug them up and swing them all away. Cooking on a ranch.
And tell them all you wish they were your girls.
Them bucking broncs are snorting, cowboys riding high, longhorns pawing up the big corral.
Waiting for the battle, a bell ring in the chutes, and a cowboy shout right up to their pals.
We're a jolly bunch of cowboys, we hope you are the same.
In trouble. How?
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 How do I get to Calgary?
You are welcome to join us, my brother.
Yeah!
What makes Calgary so special during the Stampede is not only the excitement in the Stampede grounds. The whole city becomes one big frontier town. Square dancing on the streets, western bands on almost every corner, and free flapjacks and sausages and coffee. It's that time of the year when doctors, lawyers, and presidents become cowboys, and nurses and secretaries and housewives become cowgirls. It's a time I don't think that anyone would want to miss. And it all starts off with the Calgary Stampede opening day parade.
in Bronx in the promised tears are a match for the cowboy's ball. The whistle blow, chuck wagon roll, drivers meet the test. C-A-L-G-A-R-1, the heart of the Golden West. C-A-L-G-A-R-1, welcome to the big stampede. C-A-L-G-A-R-1, see the cowboys in the lead. C-A-L-G-A-R-1, the town we all love best. C-A-L-G-A-R-1, the heart of the Golden West. Everybody join in the big parade, hear the cowboys yell.
Hear me!
Let them flapjacks in the bands, let's square dance for a spell. Rope that gal, that pretty little gal, the one that you love best. C-A-L-G-A-R-1, the heart of the Golden West. C-A-L-G-A-R-1, the heart of the Golden West.
Well, here's what all happens. In the infield of the Stampede Grounds, where riders from all over the world will compete for over $150,000 in prizes. Now, before the events officially begin, I'd like you to meet three of the most interesting men that you'll find anywhere. One of them is an ex-rodeo rider. He's Canada's first star of Western music, Wilf Carter. The 10 times world champion Chuckwagon Driver, Dick Cosgrove. And one of the original saddle bronc riders in the very first Calgary Stampede way back in 1912, Jim Ryan. And I must say, it's a great honor for me to be in such company, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Now, fellas, while I've got you here, there's something I'd like you to clear up for me. The story goes that back somewhere in the 1880s, a few of the boys at the end of a cattle run were hooping it up, and they decided to have a little fun. And they bet their wages on who could rope a calf the quickest or stay up on a wild horse the longest. And this idea spread to what we now know to be the rodeo, right? Now, is that the way it happened, Jim?
That's the way it happened, Lorne. And according to the old-timers, they stated that every once in a while, they had a rodeo from one ranch to the other.
Jim, how old were you when you started all this steer riding and bronc busting? What got you started in it?
I started in steer riding in 1913 at Galician, and I was not the best steer rider in the world, but I will admit that I won the first prize there, perhaps due to the fact the other boys got bucked off, you know. Now, at the present time, they have Brahma bull riding, and between the wild steer riding and wild bull riding we had back in 12 and 13 and 14, I must admit that these Brahma bulls at the present time are much more difficult to ride than they were when we rode them.
How old were you when you started steer riding?
Well, I was a kid about 18.
What got you interested in it?
Well, it was just a question of the boys bragging on the roundup that they could do this and they could do that. And doggone, I figured that maybe I was as good as any of them, you know what I mean? But I wasn't too good neither.
Now we come to bareback bronking. Now that's tough. I know it's real tough. And the limit is what, 8 seconds? I suppose that would be about the longest 8 seconds that a human being could possibly stand.
The way these boys tell me, it sure is a long time. And they have to leave with their spurs up above the point of the shoulder and keep scratching, and one hand on a rigging is all. And the other hand's got to be free of the horse and equipment all the time. And it's a long 8 seconds of them.
Now, wild cow milking, that's the wildest sight of all. Tell me about that.
Well, Lorne, I believe it is. They turn a bunch of these old wild cows loose. There's generally a lot more cowboys than there is cows. And, of course, there's a roper and a milker. And my old partner, sitting alongside of me here, Dick Cosgrove, he used to rope them, and I used to milk them. And whoever could get the milk in the pop bottle about as quick as he could and head for the judge's stand, he generally won it. And I would say it's one of the greatest events in the Stampede.
How many of these did you win?
Oh, I couldn't say how many. I was in there. I got enough for to get the wolf away from the door.
You're well, still poking up.
What about that wild horse race?
Well, Lorne, it's a kind of a wild event. If you got a arena that you can turn them all out together and do it.
How does that do? What happens? You have, how many men do you have to have?
Three men, and one rides, and one ears, and the other holds the horse head.
Well, what do you mean, one ears?
One got to go up and get the ears.
Ear him down.
Well, I think you excel in different things, and I think that that was one of the things I love to get in on. And Dick says you twist their ears down. Yes, you do, but you can't touch the halter in any way until the whistle blows or they say go. That's when I used to love to jump and grab the horse with this arm up around his neck, and I would grab his ears in my teeth, and I would sit there.
You'd bite him?
Oh, yeah, I always bit his ears. And they seemed to calm down, and then, of course, like Dick said, you saddle them up and get on them, and then you take your old hat and you fan them, and you get out the other end, whoever puts them through the gate wins the prize.
You say that when you bite the ear, it calmed them down.
Yeah, sure it is. They like it.
They like it. By gosh, if you bit my ears, I don't think I'd calm down.
You're still poking them.
You say it calms them down, right? But what about the dentist bills?
Well, I tell you one time, Lorne, I reached for the horse real quick, and they used to yell at me from the stand up there, the judges. They say, don't touch that horse, Carter. Don't touch the halter. You know, wait. I said, I'm not touching him. I'm just waiting. And when, of course, when they said go, I jumped and I grabbed him. But one time I missed, and his foot hit in the mouth. He shook hands with me and I lost a couple of teeth.
Now, Dick, you're the 10-times world champion chuck wagon racer. And that's quite a feat. How did they get started here?
When we first started, the wagon races in Calgary was handled a lot different then. You came in with your, you raced with your team hooked up around the track. There was no turning barrels. And you raced the track, and then you pulled into the center field with the back of your wagon to the grandstand, unhooked your team and tied him to the side of the wagon. And first, with the stove out of the back and smoke coming out of the chimney, won the wagon. Well, it got so, there was no, it got so jippled that you'd be unhooking your team and I'd come in late hollering beside you. And your team would race on down the infield. And it really wasn't a sport. So after a few years of that, well, then they built it up to more or less an art. Turn the barrels and all go the same distance and around the racetrack.
Tell me, is it a dangerous sport?
Well, it's a sport. And they're raised to it or come up into it. It's a thrill to them. And they just take their chances. It's the same with Bronc riding or bull riding. Why, they'd really take chances on all those sports.
You got to be real tough to be
one. Yeah, sure do. Yeah.
Now, we got something special. We managed to get a hold of a film of one of the earliest chuck wagon races ever run at the Stampede back in the 20s. So hold on to your hats and your britches, because here they go. You know, there's no question of the unparalleled excitement here in the infield watching the best riders and ropers in the world. But when evening falls, the undisputed entertainment champion of the Calgary Stampede is a group of 80 boys and girls, youngsters from the age of 7 to seasoned veterans of 21. They're all from the city of Calgary. So it's with great pride that I say to you, ladies and gentlemen, the young Canadians.
Living the life free as a breeze. We like to play, like to sing, like climb in the top rung. Happy as birds in the trees.
When we see a girl dervish, we whirl like a dervish and hang our heels as we spin.
Singing ding-a-ling, it must be spring.
So glad that the sun rose today.
If we seem a bit silly or act willy-nilly, our brains on the head of a pin,
it don't mean a thing, it's only spring and the moon we're in. Merry May, joyful June, on a summer's eve, merry-go-round. Time to play.
To my lips, to my arms, and then that's it.
Park, which has been carefully restored to resemble a town, a western town, at the turn of the century. Does it look familiar to you? But it does. Not too different from the hundreds of towns like it that you've seen in the Hollywood Western. You see, the rodeo is the last remaining authentic spirit of the Old West. But the Western has kept the Old West alive in our imagination. For example, this street here. Isn't this where Billy the Kid met up with someone who thought he could outdraw him? Or, this hotel. Couldn't this be where Wild Bill Hickok came to play his last game of poker when Wild Bill thought he had the best hand with aces and eights? And someone had a better one? A 45? And that blacksmith shop? I know. That's where Gene Autry would go to get Champion a new pair of shoes. Now, you see that stagecoach that just arrived? Well, it's going to be leaving soon with a large shipment of gold. And it's going to be traveling through some very rough and dangerous country. Well, I'll be. That Dale Evans, eh? Well, I hope she has a safe journey. But if they do run into any trouble, I know someone who's always around to lend a helping hand. The King of the Cowboys, Roy Rogers.
Oh, give me land, lots of land under starry skies above. Don't fence me in Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze and listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please, don't fence me in. Just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies. On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. Ride to the ridge where the west commences and gaze at the moon until I lose my senses. I can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in.
You all right?
Well, I believe so.
You should be all right from here on in. Those extras won't bother you anymore.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Well, ma'am, I'm Roy Rogers.
Mr. Rogers, I can't thank you enough.
Just call me Roy.
You can call me Dale.
Well, thank you, ma'am. Say, my ranch is just over that hill, and after a ride like that, you probably want to kind of rest and freshen up a bit.
You sure are a fancy talker.
Well, I'll get the buggy for you and we'll be right back.
And I'll be waiting.
There's silver on the sage tonight, sprinkled by the moon above. So lie down, dogies, and let me dream of the one that I love. There's silver on the sage tonight. We've been on the trail all day. So lie down, dogies, and you dream too of a range far away, of a range waiting for you, where the streams never go dry and the grass sparkles with dewdrops in the meadows of the sweet by and by. There's silver on the sage tonight, sprinkled by the moon above. So lie down, dogies, and let me dream of the one that I.
I hope it wasn't too long.
Oh, no, I've been enjoying this beautiful country.
Up you go. You know, I never sat this close to someone as pretty as you before.
For a man that rides the great wide open spaces, you're sure some silver-tongued devil.
With someone like you, a pal so good and true, I'd like to leave it all behind and go and find
some place that's known to God alone. Just a spot to call our own. We'll find perfect peace where joys will never cease. Out there beneath the kindly sky, we'll build a sweet little nest somewhere out in the west, and let the rest of the world
you.
You're welcome. Going back to the barn, boys. The hands will take care of you.
Bye-bye. Well, I declare.
Dale, I'd like you to meet Gabby. Gabby, say hello to Miss Dale.
How do you do?
Howdy, ma'am.
I think I will freshen up a bit. You're cute.
You're cute.
Roy, why, you dad-burned, dad-blamed, dad-gummed whippersnapper. If I've told you once, I've told you 1,000 times. Them fancy women are not to be trusted.
Oh, but Miss Dale's different.
Come and get it.
Well, I feel like a new woman.
Well, that's good. You're just in time for dinner. What do you say we go meet the other boys?
Good.
I'm a roving cowboy, far away from home, far from the prairie that I used to roam, where the doggies wander and the wind blows free. Oh, my heart is young.
Oh, Dale, Dale, I heard about the stagecoach. Are you all right, my precious?
Yes, thanks to Mr. Rogers.
Well, I can't thank you enough, Mr. Rogers.
You can call me Roy.
You can call me Rufus.
Roy, I'd like you to meet my fiancé, Rufus Poindexter.
We've met.
Well, Dale, my precious, we'd better be going. We'll be late for our own wedding.
Yes.
I told you, Roy, I told you.
They sure make a fine couple.
Oh, Roy.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then. Happy trails to you till we
After 9 days of competition, we're now down to the very final day, a time when the best riders, ropers, and drivers come face to face with their own personal judgment. Now, no doubt that this is the most exciting, most anxious moment of the Stampede for both riders and spectators. And before the actual final start, the Calgary Stampede has something very special for the folks, something that's rarely seen. The participating are the young braves from five tribes, the Stonies, Sarcees, Pagan, Bloods, and Blackfoot. It's a wild and woolly buffalo ride. And it's wild and woolly. And there's the signal for the start, and away they go. Uh-huh. Time to get off. Time to leave. Time to go. Discretion has always been the better part of valor. Yes, sir, and still champion, the Buffalo. And here comes the champion of the steer wrestling event. Bob Marshall from St. Martin, California. Watch this champion bulldogger. He does it in 4.4 seconds. Those quarter horses, by the way, are specially trained to squeeze the steer or haze him. There he is, Bob Marshall, champion steer wrestler. We're looking at the bull riding event, just about to start. And this is the champion, Phil Lyon, from George, West Texas. He's riding a little animal called Blue Cross. And look at him go. Keep riding there. Keep going. Keep right on top of him. All he has is a heavy rope with a built-in handhold. Well, he not only won the bulls, but he's a Calgary Stampede all-round champion. And last year's world champion cowboy, Phil Lyon, from George, West Texas. Now we're going to watch a team event, a wild horse race. The Don Copperthorne team from Cochrane, Alberta, is team number 86. They won the event. Now, this is what you have to do. You take horses that have never been saddled, totally unbroken, and you ride them. That's all. It takes three men to do it, though. One of them holds the horse, one of them bites the horse's ear, and one of them saddles the horse. They tell me you bite the ear to calm down the horse. I don't know if that'll calm me down. Anyway, they better do it in the order I mentioned. You hold him, you bite him, and you saddle him. All right? Now, Wilf never did tell us what his dentist bill was when he was biting the ear. There he is. Cinch that horse up now. So, grab hold of him. Grab hold of him. But I'm told the dentist looking after these cowboys takes his... Wait a minute now. Wait a minute. Cinch him. The dentist looking after these cowboys takes his whole family for a grand vacation every year. Now, the horse won't move. Watch it. Watch it. There he is. My horse does that. Oh, there he goes. Now, this is Capro, and Ron Seawall from Chico, Texas, won this with a score of 13.3, total time 42.1 seconds. It's a symphony of a horse and man, the horse holding the rope taut without putting the cap at all, or else it's penalized. Ron carries a pigging string in his mouth. You loop one front foot and cross over the two back feet. Two wraps and a hooey. There he is, the world champion Capro. Bareback Bronc riding is not the easiest event in the world, but Joe Alexander from Cora, Wyoming, scored a 76 riding Cindy Rocket, the 1969 Horse of the Year. Form is important. Keep your right hand high, your feet ahead of the shoulder of the horse, going with the rhythm of the horse, and spurring all the time. You have a judge on either side, judging the horse and the rider. If you have a good horse, you win. If you have a bad horse, you can be the best rider and lose. The cowboys have their own brand of humor, and wild cow milking represents it. This is a crazy event, because what you see here are range cows who have never seen the inside of a barn. And the only one who's ever come close to milking them before this have been their own calves. But these cowboys have to rope these wild cows and milk them, and fill up an old-time pint milk bottle and get it to the judge without spilling a drop. Now, these cows are mean. They're not that easy, you see? Now, there's one that's been roped. And now, let's see if we can get that bottle underneath there to fill it up. Hold on now, hold on tight. There comes the bottle, and there goes the man. I know one fellow who milks so many cows that he shakes hands one finger at a time. Now he gets to the judge and deposits his milk. Now, a drop. Here's another one now. He's just about ready. Whoops. Easy now. There he goes, too. Now, these cows are held by the clowns who do a tremendous job. You know, many clowns have saved a lot of cowboys from hurt and or embarrassment. There's a cow being held and mothered by an old clown. And easy now. Easy now. Hold on. Straighten that out now. Get that pool. I don't know if you're going to have the cream for your coffee. Yep, I guess he is. And that's it, the event won by Pat McHugh. Now, this is the classic event of the rodeo, the saddle bronc ride. And the man who won it is Darrell Cobb, who scored a 67 riding American Express. And it looks like an express ride. Darrell Cobb lives in Wyoming. He was born in Australia. He's Chinese. He could have been penalized for a slow start, but he scored an unbelievable 80 on his first ride. And so he is the saddle bronc riding champion of the world. Darrell Cobb. This is the Chuckwagon race, the real exciting event of the Calgary Stampede. Now, this is not just a race. Certain things have to be done in a certain order. Each wagon has four outriders. Number one holds the lead team, puts his own horse. Number two holds his horse and throws in the stove. Number three and four hold their horses and throw in the tent poles from the rear of the rig. When the klaxon is sounded, the action is gone. The Chuckwagon plus the outriders who have mounted their horses make a figure eight around the barrels and head for the track and make one circuit, half a mile. Now, you can be penalized for knocking over a barrel or for your outriders either coming in ahead of the chuck wagons or too far behind it.
Now you're going to see Kelly Sutherland, a fearless 21-year-old driver, steal the rail and win the race. But he's not going to win the world's championship, because Ralph Vegan, who came in second, was penalty-free on this race. Sutherland was penalized 1 second for a late outrider. He was just too fast for him. And now over the 10 heats, they ride every day the Stampede. Ralph Vegan won by .0083 of a second. Kelly Sutherland's late outrider cost him the world's championship. So number one comes second. Number two wins the world's championship, Ralph Vegan. And here it is, and what a race!
Never in this land before us, and nevermore hereafter, for the land knows such a man as the cowboy. His unique brand of lingo, his boots, his bandana, all his devil deeds of daring, his clothes, his way of living. Listen to the cowboy's story. And if you cannot hear it in these legends, songs, and stories, listen closely to the west wind and the secrets that it whispers in the forest, plains, and valleys, in the sands, forever shifting.
When it's twilight on the trail, and I jog along, the world is like a dream, and the ripple of the stream is my song.
And the ripple of the stream is my song.
When it's twilight on the trail, and I rest once more, my ceiling is the sky, and the grass on which I lie is my floor.
And the grass on which I lie is my floor.
All day I faced a barren waste without the taste of water. Cool water.
You listen to him then, he's a devil, not a man, and he spreads the burning sand with water.
Water.
Then can you see that big green tree where the water's running free, and it's waiting there for me and you?
Carpet of green and a sky blue roof above.
I'm welcome there alone or with the one I love.
In your heart, take a good look. If you follow the good book, you're sure to find your reward.
Oh, the place where I worship is the wide open spaces.
along, boys, and listen to my tale. I'll tell you all my troubles on the old Chisholm Trail. Come a tie-yi, yippee-yippee-yay, yippee-yay. Come a tie-yi, yippee-yippee-yay. It's cloudy in the west, and it looks like rain. And my darned old slicker's in the wagon again. Come a tie-yi, yippee-yippee-yay, yippee-yay. Come a tie-yi, yippee-yippee-yay. I mounted up the bus to draw my roll. Well, they figured me out, $9 in the hole. Come a tie-yi, yippee-yippee-yay, yippee-yay. Come a tie-yi, yippee-yippee-yay.
I was going down the road with a tired team and a heavy load. I come to the river and I couldn't get across, so I traded my wife for an old gray horse. Turkey in a straw.
Turkey in a straw.
Turkey in a hay.
Turkey in a hay.
Roll him up, tie him up a high, tuck a haul, and twist him on a tune called Turkey in a Straw.
Roll him up, tie him up high, tuck a haul, and twist him on a tune called Turkey in a Straw.
Spring time in the Rockies, I'm coming back to you, little sweetheart on the mountain, with your bonnie eyes so blue. Once again I'll say I love you, while the birds sing all the day. When it's springtime in the Rockies, in the Rockies far away.
Calgary Stampede Diamond Jubilee has been brought to you by the First Canadian Bank, Bank of Montreal.
Although the Old West is steeped in the history of the past, the West today represents the spirit of the future, the spirit of moving forward, but never forgetting its heritage. As long as there are green fields, there'll be men to till them. As long as there are wild horses, there'll be men to ride them. And as long as there are frontiers, there will always be men to open. I hope you've enjoyed your visit with us,
And until we meet again, good night from the Calgary Stampede and the heart of the Golden West.